People often say that nothing good comes for free, and when it comes to digital security, that's usually true, but is it always the case? In this best free antivirus for Windows 11 review, I'm gonna break down the top options that offer solid protection, important security features, and great performance, all without costing you a cent. Let's dive in. Okay, let's start with the TotalAV free antivirus plan. TotalAV lets its free users enjoy malware scans to detect and remove threats. The downside is that the free version of TotalAV doesn't offer real-time protection, meaning that threats are only detected by manual scans. This is a big security risk since malware could lurk in your device without you being notified. Moving on, TotalAV also offers anti-phishing protection, which blocks malicious websites, and that's it for the free features TotalAV offers. Now, I know it's not a lot, but it doesn't cost a penny, and it's not bad for users who just need an occasional security checkup. On top of that, you're safer from phishing attempts, so it's a win in my book. But what about the security and performance? In my research where I put different antivirus providers to the test, I found that TotalAV removed 80 threats out of 100, which is not a bad score at all for a free tool. Moreover, TotalAV scan was not harsh on the CPU, which is nice, reaching 30 to 80%. Lastly, TotalAV does have various certifications and several awards under its belt, so it is recognized in the market. Cool, the performance is decent, but what about ease of use? Now, in my opinion, this is one of TotalAV's strengths. The application feels modern and really accessible, with most settings and features being pretty much self-explanatory. As you can see, navigating the user interface is easy, whether you have any tech background or not. All of this is good, but TotalAV's free version does have some cons, one of them being frequent ads inviting me to upgrade to a paid version, and the other being its limited use. Also, I could test TotalAV only on one device, so that's worth keeping in mind if you opt for this provider. But of course, me being me, I decided to test the paid TotalAV version as well. There's a 30-day money-back guarantee, so it's not like I was risking anything. As a side note, just for a few bucks a month, you can grab a deal using my link in the description as well, so go get that. Anyway, my experience using the premium version of TotalAV was great. I could access many more features like advanced ransomware protection and system optimization tools. I like the former, especially useful as they boosted the responsiveness of my device. There's also even a VPN and password manager available, and of course, real-time protection. So after this short TotalAV antivirus review, I can already easily conclude that the free version of TotalAV is pretty okay, but the paid one is definitely miles better, as one would expect. By the way, if you'd like to get the best deal for TotalAV, scan the QR code on screen or just click the link in the description. All right, moving on in this best free antivirus review, it's time to look at the one and only Bitdefender. This provider has been a staple name in the industry for years now, proving its experience as one of the best antiviruses out there, okay? But does this extend to its free version as well? Now, first, liked that the malware scanner for detecting and removing various threats is free, okay? It even allowed me to scan external drives, which is cool. Next, a big one, there's real-time protection even for free users. Yeah, you heard me right. It's amazing, okay? As it's a must-have feature, and free antiviruses typically just don't give it out. So Bitdefender further shines with its advanced threat defense feature, which uses behavioral detection to monitor active apps and just take immediate action if anything suspicious is detected. And lastly, online threat prevention protects against malicious websites. Honestly, I was taken aback by all the functionality that Bitdefender offers for free, and there are no annoying ads either. However, the Bitdefender free version still has its faults, so the free version is good on Windows, but even then it lacks firewall and system optimization tools. Furthermore, Bitdefender's features are limited severely on mobile, but if you don't want to use it on other operating systems, I gotta admit, Bitdefender is good for essential use. Now, the performance is also fantastic, with Bitdefender removing 85 threats out of 100 while utilizing around 1 to 11% of the CPU during my testing, which is just outstanding, actually. But it's not all sunshine and rainbows, okay? Bitdefender does its job well, but man, does it take time. It took over an hour to complete the scan. Furthermore, while Bitdefender is not as easy to use, at least at first glance, it's still really accessible. And yes, as you already guessed, I tested the premium Bitdefender version as well, since the free version is still insufficient to protect from, you know, every kind of threat. Like TotalAV, there's a 30-day money-back guarantee, so I could test it with no strings attached. My most notable findings were the ransomware protection feature, which prevents any attempts to have your files encrypted and held for ransom. I also like the privacy firewall, which can be understood as a guard of my network. It tracks all connections and notices if there are any unauthorized attempts to access it, improving my safety. There's a password manager and a VPN as well to keep all my passwords safe and sound in one place. The VPN It's more of a gimmick though, as only 200 megabytes of bandwidth is granted. And in this day and age, 200 megabytes is peanuts, if I'm being frank, and I'd have to pay extra to raise the limit. Boom. In short, Bitdefender is one of the best free antivirus for Windows 11, but it's still insufficient for complete privacy. Nevertheless, I did enjoy testing Bitdefender a lot, and I just wish that the free version was as good on other operating systems as it is on Windows. I left the best discount for Bitdefender in the description below, so you can enjoy the free version of that. Don't hesitate to get the premium though, if you're so inclined. All right, lastly, we need to discuss Avira in this best free antivirus review. So fun fact, Avira was first released in 1988. Actually, it's the first antivirus that I've ever used. It's basically a dinosaur in the cybersecurity world, which managed to keep up with the best of the industry for all these years. So let's discuss its features. So Avira's tool belt is stacked with both standard and additional features, even for its free users, which I found to be very impressive at first. The Avira version includes malware scans, system optimization tools to make your device run smoother, and even real-time protection. I mean, if the free features stopped here, it would already be enough. But Avira further pushes the envelope with its password manager to help keep your passwords safe and a file shredder to destroy sensitive files completely. And there's also safe shopping, which blocks malicious and phishing websites. It also finds the best deals for you. Of course, some of the features like the password manager or the VPN are limited in Avira's free version. For example, the VPN only gives 500 megabytes of bandwidth monthly, and the password manager doesn't allow me to autofill credentials. This kind of defeats one of the main purposes of a password manager, and the VPN feels kind of like a gimmick with its data limitation. Now, this brings me to my next point. Avira's performance is decent. During my testing, it removed 79 malware out of 100 and completed the scan in just 10 minutes. At the same time, I found Avira to be accessible, but the free version can be annoying at times. So ads are frequent. So if you daily drive the free version, chances are you're gonna kind of grow bored of it. Now, overall, Avira's free plan is good, but not optimal. There are many features, though some of them are just there to upsell you, which can be really inconvenient at times. Now, all of this changes with Avira's premium subscription. Many more features are added, just to name a few: a firewall, ransomware protection, email protection, web protection, and customer support, which you can contact via phone as well, by the way. Since there were no ads and no features locked, my overall experience was much more enjoyable. And in any case, I gotta conclude that Avira is a really good free antivirus for Windows 11. You won't be disappointed if you go for it. That said, I do recommend getting the premium version. You can click the link in the description to get the best deal as well, so feel free to grab it there. So what are my final thoughts after this review? Are there any good antiviruses after all? Yes, but they all have different caveats, such as device limitations or upsells. Anyway, I hope you find the perfect one for your needs. And as a reminder, the best available deals are in the description below. And if you enjoyed this video, just watch the next one right here. Watch that one. Okay, see ya, bye.